Hello, Selamat sejahtera. Ni hao, Vanakkam, Namaste, Sawadee, Annyeonghaseyo, Konnichiwa. Welcome to CHIS News. I'm Mr. Myles, and I'm the very lucky principal of this amazing school, Crescendo-HELP International School. Quick reminder, you can get the subtitles in about 15 different languages. Just click on the settings icon. Well, this week, I'm going to show you something amazing. And I have right here some of our wonderful young scientists who are going to help me. But to do that, we have to go up on the roof. Should we go? Okay, let's go.
So the exciting news is that our school is now generating its own electricity. These massive solar panels have been installed right across the roof of the building and also on the gym. And together, this represents our school's commitment to reducing our carbon footprint, which is good for the planet. But also over the long term, this is going to mean a reduction in costs, which is good for all of us.
So up here, we have this amazing technology installed. But the question is, how does it actually work? What is really going on here? So I'm very fortunate to have my young scientists explain it to me. Can you tell me, to the best of your knowledge, hold on to that. Can you tell me, to the best of your knowledge, how does this really work? What's happening?
So the solar panels absorb the solar energy from the sun. Mm-hmm. And yeah, they produce their own electricity to give us like air cons and all those electrical devices.
Right.
I think that's how I know.
Okay, well, good. Well, let's pass it along. And can you tell us some more about how does it work? How does it turn sunlight into electricity?
I think he also said it's correct. And then I think he said absorb the sunlight, right? And after that, it will like turn it into the energy, like the light turn into the energy. Then it can slowly turn them into like electricity.
Fascinating. Well, thank you. So you're both in year five. And if we pass it over to our A-level students, who are really, really dedicated scientists, because they've chosen to study physics and many other science subjects at a high level. Let's see if they can add some more information for us.
Essentially, the solar panel is made up of multiple solar cells. Each of them generate 5 volts, and a singular solar panel has 3 layers, but you can think of it as 2 N and P. There's one layer made up of multiple electrons, another layer made up of multiple holes, and they form this entire layer called a PN junction, which is essentially how the entirety of the solar panel works.
So for the N and P solar region, it was made of silicon atom, which they are bonded to each other with 4 covalent bonds, which they're sharing electrons, and means that they are immobilized electrons and they can't move around. So when the electrons, they absorb the light energy from the sun, they will be ejected out, move around the external circuit and provide energy.
We have something called depletion layer in between the positive and negatively charged layers. And there are neutral atoms in the depletion layer where the photon hits them and they will break off and form free charge carriers.
So basically, photons is a discrete energy packet in the light. As the frequency of light increases, the number of photons will be increasing as well. When the frequency exceeds a certain limit for the metal, the photons, so the electrons in the solar panel will get sufficient energy, which is kinetic energy, to be emitted out from the solar panel. Hence, they will be able to move around the external circuit, allowing the current to flow.
However, just because it's very sunny does not mean that the solar panel will be 100% efficient. It operates better at a sort of median temperature between 35 and 40-ish degrees, roughly room temperature. But if it exceeds that, for instance, it was 50 degrees outside today, for example, the solar panel will be as good because there will be too much energy entering it, and as a result, more is removed because it cannot handle it as an entire system. Yep, that's pretty much it.
Well, thank you. That was amazing. And you're very, very knowledgeable, all of you. Did you find that interesting? Yeah, they seem to know a lot about how it works, so photons and things like that. So there's so much more for us to learn. Do you feel you know everything there is to know about that?
Nope. There's so much to discover.
There's more and more, isn't there? Is there a limit? Not really. You can spend a lifetime going deeper and deeper into all of these areas. So that's the fascinating thing about being a lifelong learner. And I have to say, I really love these sunglasses because there's a lot of photons out here, and it really, really helps to protect the eyes from that. So anyway, thank you all for your contribution and for coming up here to show us this and explain it to us. I learned something. And I'm really grateful. Thank you very much. Well done. So what we can see from listening to our students is that they all understand at some level. But one of the reasons why this school produces outstanding young scientists is that we understand that also they build understanding over time. Learning, not just in science, in any subject, is process of developing conceptual understanding, and we revisit and learn in layers. You add new information, new skills to deepen understanding. That's how the process really takes place. Well, we'll follow up in another video with some of our science teachers very soon, so look out for that one. But that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with friends and family. Bye-bye.